Hello everyone and welcome to today's webinar. This is Stephanie Roodhouse, the Director of Customer Marketing and Communications at Replicon. I'm joined by my colleague Mattie Punakha. He's our team lead of solutions engineering. So thank you for taking the time to join us for the webinar on expense tracking made effortless. Before we begin, we'd like to just go over a few housekeeping items. You will be on mute during the presentation. There will be a Q&A at the end of the webinar. And you can always submit any questions you have through the Q&A text box located on the right-hand side of your screen. And if there's any questions you have for the moderator, please do use that chat function. So let's get started with a poll question. We just are a little curious how you're tracking employee expenses today. So you should have four options here to select: paper-based, Excel, manual, or other. Please go ahead and select the best choice for you. Mattie, given your experience working with customers and other folks interested in Replicon solutions, where would you say that we're going to get the most selections?
I would say Excel. Most of the prospects that we work on a day-to-day basis use Excel. So my vote is towards Excel.
Great. Well, you're right on there, Mattie. It looks like 75% of the respondees did indicate Excel, and there's 25% that said other. So congratulations. You have a pretty good understanding about what some of our customers and prospects are using to track employee expenses today. So with that in mind, we'd love to hear more about Web Expense.
Wonderful. Thank you for that, Stephanie. Yes, this is very much anticipated. As I mentioned earlier, this is what most of our prospects mentioned to us during our demonstration. So yes, that is much more anticipated. Now, I want to take this opportunity to welcome everyone for this webinar, Expense Tracking Made Effortless. Today, we are going to see how seamlessly Replicon's expense module could be used to track expenses and being in labor compliant and workforce regulations. Now, currently, you're seeing the My Replicon section, which would be the landing page from an end user perspective. So as an end user, when I log into the expense section, it is going to straight away take me to this dashboard view where I can see the historical expenses that I've submitted in the past filters based on the status of those expenses. Now, if I have to request for a new expense, all I need to do is click on Add Expense, which is going to take me to this expense sheet where I can put in a brief description the reason I am requesting for this expense. So let's say I went to a seminar at a client place in LA. I can put that as my description. I can also tag this expense to a relevant client in a project. I could do that. Now, based on the project I choose, you can filter the expense codes. And these expense codes are all user-defined, which means I can create my own expense codes that are relevant to my organization. So let me grab one of the expense codes here. I can choose a date when I incurred this expense. I can go ahead and put in a brief description for the expense code that I'm reimbursing. If I need to bill my client, I can need to check this option. I need to get a reimbursement. I can also choose the payment method. In the payment method, you can also define if you're allowing any of your corporate cards. So the employee can choose the appropriate payment method and enter the amount that they might have incurred towards those expenses and upload the appropriate receipts. Now, since we are on the cloud, we have the smartphone app, the native app for Android and iPhone, which means as an employee, I can use my iPhone app and, you know, take a photocopy of my receipt and submit my expense that way, which we're going to cover at a later stage during this demonstration or during this webinar. Now, I can also choose all the expenses that I might have incurred towards that visit and submit it for approval. Now, we have a workflow towards the expenses. So based on the workflow that has been set up, you can go up to 5 levels of approval if required, which means the expense can go to 5 different people or 5 different roles of people. So based on that, I can submit it for approval. So once I submit, an automatic email notification would be sent out to my approver or a supervisor who's going to land up in this team section. Now, before I move into the team section, a couple of things that I want to highlight with regards to the expense section here is Let's say instead of LA, I went to a different geographical location where I incurred my currency in a different currency, but the reimbursement I want in dollars, or it could be the other way around as well. So that is something we do support as well. So just want to highlight on that. So this is pretty much with regards to the end user view of an expense sheet. Now moving on to the supervisor or an approvers view, the team section is where I would be landing as an approver, where I would see all the expenses that are waiting for my approval. So on a high level, I get to see the dashboard view where I can see the employee, the description, and the amount for which he has submitted. So I can approve or reject the expense right from here, or I can drill down into the expense sheet to see the receipts that the employer submitted and if it's matching with the amount that he is requesting. There we go. So I can click on any of the receipts here, verify the receipts. If everything looks good, I can go ahead and approve or reject the expense. Now, either I approve or reject the expense, I'll be prompted with a comment field where I can enter any high-level comment with regards to the expense, and then I can reject or approve. Now, either I approve or reject an expense, an email will be triggered to my approver or to the end user stating that the expense has been approved or either rejected, and any comment as an approver I might have entered over here. Now, if you've given the permission for a supervisor to edit, he can always edit, make the necessary corrections, and approve the expense from there. And any changes made to the expense sheet will be captured in our audit trial report. Now, for auditing purpose, if you have to take a printout of this expense sheet, again, that is an option available. And just to give you an understanding of how the the printout would look like, this is how the expense sheet would look for your auditing purpose. A nice view of that as well. Wonderful. So this is from an approval standpoint. Now moving on to reporting. Now reporting engine at Replicon is quite robust. It gives you a lot of flexibility in terms of customizing your report. As you can see, we have a list of canned reports from where you can customize, or you could create your own report by clicking on new report, choosing the columns that you would like to track, and customizing it from there. Now let's say I'm going to use one of the reports here. Expense reimbursement is a nice report for me to see for all the expenses that has been submitted by a specific user and all the expense codes and the amount that we need to actually reimburse to that employee. So as you can see here, I've kind of currently grouped it by client and then by the user. I can see the department for which he's going to work, the expense codes that he has incurred, and also the amount and the reimbursable amount that we need to reimburse to that employee. Now, since I've grouped it by client, it's going to summarize at that level. Now, let's say in this report, there are a couple of columns that I would love to have, which is missing in this report. All you need to do is go into settings where you have all the data points that you need in terms of reporting perspective. So I can choose all the columns that I need. So I can enable all the columns that I need in my report. Now, once I've added those columns, I can group them. Currently, it's grouped by client and then by the user. If you need multiple grouping, again, that is an option available. You can also arrange the columns exactly where you want to see by dragging and dropping it exactly where I want to see that in my report. I can also create custom columns. So when I say custom columns, this is very important. So let's say I want to go ahead and use the logical operators or logical conditions. So using that, I can easily go ahead and determine a value for me. So I can choose the format that value needs to appear in my report. I can also name the column exactly the way it needs to show in my report. What it means is most of the slicing and dicing that we do in Excel, you could manage all of that within Replicon. Now, once you have added all the necessary columns, you can go ahead and run the report, and it will make the changes, or any columns that we have added will be added into that report. And any report that you pull in Replicon, you can easily export that to Excel. I can export that to a PDF. I can also email that to someone right from here. Now, one of the key functionality that our reporting offers is the scheduling of report. So when I say scheduling, What I mean to say here is you can choose the recurrence exactly when I want to see this report. So let's say expense reimbursement is a nice report for me to see every week. So let's say starting from next week, I want this report to be sent to me at 9 a.m. I can also add all the users that I want to be a part of this report. I can also choose the format the report needs to be sent to those users. And once I schedule, every week an email will be sent to all these users with a report that they need to see in the format they need to see, which means I don't even have to log into Replicon to run a report. Replicon will send a report on the time frame that I've scheduled in the format that they are supposed to see. Again, a very nice functionality to have in terms of reporting. Now, in terms of the administration capabilities, some of the email notifications I do want to show you. So for instance, whenever the expenses have been submitted, it keeps notifying the users or the supervisors. So again, this is a very nice template that we can enable. And also, the best part is you can change the content of that email right from here. Like if you want to change the subject of that email or with regards to the body of that email, again, that is a flexibility available. You can also choose when this notification should go out at this hour, so you can define all of those. And the best part is this email is not a text format, it is a pure HTML format, a nice interface to have as well. Now with that, I'm going to share my iPhone here just to show you how it's going to look on your iPhone device from an end user standpoint. So I'm going to go ahead and share my screen. I'm sure you're able to see my screen now. Stephanie, you want to confirm?
Yes, we can.
Wonderful. So as you can see, as soon as I log into Replicon app, you will directly be moving into the expense section, where again, it's going to show me the historical expenses that I've submitted. So I can see it right from here. Now, let's say I am requesting for a new expense. All I need to do is click on the plus sign on the top right-hand corner. Let me put an expense sheet title here. So let's say I'm going to call it as Test 1. I can choose a date when I'm filling this. I can choose the currency that I incurred. And then I'm going to save it. So my expense sheet or the expense title is ready, I can add the expense codes that I input. So I'm going to again click on plus sign here, where if I need to tag it to the client in the project, I can very well do that. And then I can choose the expense codes that I incurred. So let's say I incur the airfare. I'm going to select that. I can put in the amount that I incurred towards that. So let's say I incurred $2,000. I can put that over here. I can choose the date when I incurred. I can put in a brief description. If I need to take a photocopy of that receipt, I can click on the receipt photo here. Either I can choose from the library, or if I want to take a real snap here, let me do that. So I'm going to click on take a photo. So I have a receipt here. Yes, looks good. Did I cover everything? Yep. So I have the receipt ready here. I'm going to use this. I have my receipt attached, so I'm going to click on done here. So it confirms that receipt photo it's attached. So I need to get a reimbursement. I can choose the payment method as well. So let's say I use cash. I can choose that. And then I can save this. I can similarly, I can add all the expense codes that I incurred by pressing on that plus sign. And once I'm done, I can submit it for approval. So once it's submitted, as we mentioned, an email will be triggered to my approver. So let's see from an approval standpoint how it's going to look like. So if I'm an approver, I'll also see the approvals tab here. So when I go into the approvals tab, I can see all the pending expenses that are waiting for my approval. So I can drill down into that expense sheet. So let's say I want to verify the airfare. I want to see the receipt, so I can drill down here. Okay, everything looks good. Okay, let me verify the receipt. Oh, here we go. The receipts, I can zoom it. Okay, looks good. It matches with the amount. All right, so I can go back here and put in my comment. and approve or reject the expense right from here. Great, so this is how, from an end user or from approval standpoint, how you can submit or approve expenses. Now, let's see what we covered today with some of the best practices with regards to our solution. So today, we went through the automated system, how Replicon can improve your productivity by promoting compliance with workforce regulations and providing transparency to your employees. Easy to use expense sheets. So as you can see, our expense sheet is pretty simple, easy to use, and also it empowers employees to submit expense reports quickly and easily because it's very easy to use. We also went through some of the expense codes and tax formulas. So you can ensure accurate expense tracking with support for unlimited expense codes. And also, you can create any tax calculation that you might or your business might need. We also saw how expenses integrated expense management, so which clearly talks about the different modules Replicon provide and how Replicon can showcase as one solution even though you have added multiple modules to your existing Replicon. Now, we also went through the project-related expense tracking, where we can easily track expenses by project and client. And also, you can compare against the project expense amounts, which will be easy to bill back the expenses to client for billable work that you have done towards those projects or for those clients. And also, we went through very quickly about the mobile platform, where how easy it is to use in the mobile platform, and also how it can avoid for your employees to carry the receipts for those expenses that they might have incurred. Now, we also went through the real-time reporting with expense reports or with expense receipts, which gives us real-time visibility into reimbursable and project expenses, where we can configure our reports and easy to make reports as well. So this is pretty much what I wanted to cover for